If you don't pray, a day will come. Then your territory will become a ground of water. Hope you know that most of the clothes we are wearing now, 10 years ago, even though nobody was preaching against it, you couldn't wear it and come out of the street. There's an energy now that gives you boldness. So a lady dresses naked, she feels normal. And nobody even bother to check anymore because all of us are under the influence of that energy. You think it's normal. It's an energy. We pray so that the consciousness of God can become our operating system. I started seeing these things as visions. I was praying in Makurdi. And at a point, I began to contend with the spirit of immorality. Because I was vexed. I saw the wantonness. And I bound myself in a room for 21 days praying and fasting. And the first thing that happened, I saw a vision. And I saw beings like crocodiles. Had battles in their hands. And they were fighting on every front. I saw some men fighting with them. What is this? And as I stood on that valley, a weapon entered my hand. And the wind threw me into the battlefield. And I was fighting with them. I didn't know where I got the weapon from. I didn't know what carried me into the battlefield. And I fought. After a while, one of the elders came. And he told me to carry people to safety. And I was excused to take people to safety. And the trance left me. And I kept contemplating, what is this? On the 18th day of my fast, while I laid in the room with my eyes open, the wall opened. And a being came out of the wall. A naked woman. I laid on the floor. I tried to stand up. I couldn't. When I looked at her head was the head of a man. So I knew it was a principality. That principality that caught him paid to immorality. I began to challenge Israel. So the being came out. And he walked around me and just sat on my shoulder. I tried to push this being, no way. I tried to bite her, she didn't even know. That was when I cried, Lord, save me. And light came from up and she dematerialized. Even though she left, for 2 weeks I was struggling with lust. Because her contact with me deposited an energy that was beyond the workings of righteousness in me. I knew righteousness, but the righteousness I knew experientially was at a level. A higher energy level of darkness came upon me. And with my righteousness, I was beginning to struggle with lust. That's why you can have faith and unbelief at the same time in your soul. If faith is higher than unbelief, you see result. If unbelief is higher than faith, you will not see result. It's energy balance. It's a manipulation of darkness. So if the devil wants to take over a territory, those days they send immoral spirits. Now they open vaults and portals because the being knows that his time is remaining small. So he's fighting with all he has. They open portals in order to distort the energy balance. That's why sometimes you will come for prayer and you will sleep till you go back home. Because the level of darkness operation at that day, your hunger and your fire cannot ascend beyond it. So that darkness will choke you. You may come for the prayer excited, but energy balance. Maybe a being walked through that territory that night, you were not aware. So you rose up to pray. You thought it was prayer as usual. Your hunger is still there, but the energy that came is superior. That's why we stay in the place of prayer. To generate energy. To generate energy and to lead tight in our territory. I can come for this meeting now. I see the power of God as if it's my name. But if I tell the Holy Ghost to minister to people at the beginning of the service, I will struggle. But when I preach for 40 minutes, I have saturated this place with energy. All I need to do is Holy Ghost touch. And then people, the same people that came weak, that energy I released strengthened them. They become sensitive in the spirit. So if you can cough, the person will receive an impartation. Why? Energy balance. It's an intelligence of the spirit realm. And the devil is exploiting it. Portals opening invasions on the earth realm. Terrible operations. Even aliens are being released into this world now. Aliens as part of spiritual warfare. Do you know that spirits enter animals? And if they enter an animal, if a demon enters a snake, the demon
we now assume the subtlety of that snake, because through superimposition he can sustain the quality of that animal. If a demon enters a bird, the demon flies. The same way, if a demon enters an alien, he can take advantage of the energy of that alien. The white man called it UFO. He doesn't know what he's talking about. They say they are unrecognized flying objects. That is called intergalactic operations. Demons taking advantages of other galaxies and bringing entities into the spiritual, the physical realm. You don't know that prayer is most important now than ever. I have seen them with my eyes. The very constellations have been manipulated. The moons and the stars, manipulated. The wise men saw the star of Jesus. They knew he was a king, and they traced him to where he was. They chose to honor him. What if they came to kill him? So they will see the star of a slave. They don't care. They know that Kai, this one is a prophet. This one is a prophet. And by your star, they know that you will order the balances against darkness. So they come and give you a job. Meanwhile, God is telling you that he wants to use you as a prophet. You don't understand the implication of energy. Demonic intelligence. You don't know what wisdom can do and undo. Did you not read in the Bible, in Judges chapter 5 verse 20, that the stars fought against Sisera from their courses? So stars too can participate in warfare on earth. Wisdom. In Joshua chapter 10 verse 12, the Bible said Joshua spake in the face of all Israel. He said, let the storm stand upon the mountains of Ajalon and the moon upon Gibeon. And he said, the sun stood still and did not make haste to go down until the period of a whole day. How did he do it? Wisdom. God came to Job in Job chapter 38 from verse 31. He said, can you bind the sweet influences of Pleiades? Or can you lose the cords of Orion? Do you have the wisdom that is required to manipulate the constellations? There is a wisdom for manipulating the constellation. They are all tools of warfare. All against the earth realm that the devil is exploiting. And we come to pray, we think it's about wine. We think it's about bread. You will have all the money, but if you are not careful, the next generation will bow to the devil. So you will use your money to sponsor your child to Harvard, and she will come back a prostitute. So your money was used to destroy your child. You don't know why we need to pray. Prayer now has even come beyond just trying to see the move of God happen. Even the human race is under attack. They speak of genetic engineering, robotic engineering, and you think it's about upgrading man. Through genetic engineering, they tell you they want to modify food, and they attach things to those food grains that you eat, and those food grains make your health and immune system weak. And in the next 10 years, they come to you and tell you that certain diseases have no cure. And the only way it can be cured is to modify your DNA. And then you say they're improving your health. If your DNA is modified, the consciousness of God can be removed from your life. The reason you know God and fear God and obey God is because in your DNA is a coding to recognize God. If that consciousness is manipulated away, they can tell you what to think and believe. So your DNA can be modified to think love is sex. So you can come to church, they say love your neighbor, and you think they are telling you have sex with your neighbor. is a manipulation. So a point will come where the consciousness of God can be removed from a generation. So no matter what you pray, is nonsense. You are preaching the Bible, you are calling love, the guy is hearing sex. That's how his DNA is wired now to think. That's his processing. We pray to frustrate darkness. We pray to frustrate the agenda of darkness beyond ourselves. So they put everything together, it doesn't work. They don't know why. Because of the prayer of the saints. The Bible said in 1 Thessalonians, unto him that letteth, it's taken out of the way. That's the church. So the reason we pray is for the purpose of God to find expression. The reason we pray is that the plan and the intelligence of darkness to be frustrated. But how many can pray like that? We pray for self and appetites. Have you not studied your Bible? The men that became great with God were the men that prayed the mind of the Father. The reason you are here today is because Abraham paid the price to secure salvation. The reason you have the Bible today to read is because somebody died. Somebody's family was burnt. Somebody was slaughtered. And the Bible says, for such, the world is not worthy that their names will be mentioned. When you go to heaven, some men that were never called apostles and prophets, you'll be shocked, they'll be the most ranking men. The men that God locked in caves for many years. All they do is to send energy into the atrium. Send energy into the atrium. So you come to church, you pray, people fall under the anointing. You say, I'm anointed. You are not wise. You don't know the manipulation that makes it possible for the anointing to move in your territory. Maybe the man that is making things happen has never been seen. There are men that God have told not to see the sunlight. Send thanks to prayer. And so long as they are there, the move of God can prosper in the land.